So the difference between simple interest and compound interest can be illustrated like this. Like say, for example, you invest $100 simple interest, okay, over a number of years. And let's just say that the interest that you're getting each year is 1%. That means that each year, this investment's gonna spin off $1. And then the next year, it's gonna spin off another dollar. And the next year, it's gonna spin off another dollar. And the next year, it's gonna spin off another dollar. And you can see that now you're gonna have the original amount, $100, plus four additional dollars, 104 total. The way that compound interest works is that, say you start off with that $100 investment, right? At 1%, after a year, you're gonna have $101, okay, 101. And then now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take that $101, you're gonna calculate 1% on the $101. So now that's gonna give you how much? It's gonna give you $1.01. Okay, so now you have $102.01. And then you're gonna take the $102.01 and you're gonna calculate 1% on that. And so what happens is it's like a snowball. You know, you're rolling that snowball, and each time you roll it, it's getting a little bit larger than it did the previous time. So you keep adding more to that initial amount, and that's why it's growing and it's compounding and it's actually growing exponentially like that. Whereas with the simple interest, it's just going up at a steady rate. It's just going like that. So you're just adding $1, $1, $1. Here you're actually increasing by more than $1 each time, and the next time a little bit more than that. So let's jump into this first example. It says, find the simple interest that's earned if you invest $500 in a savings account that pays 5% simple interest. Normally savings accounts pay compound interest, but let's just say simple interest, and for 2 years. Okay, so then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna substitute in these values. So we've got I is what we're trying to calculate. P is our principal, which is the $500, the initial amount. The rate, which is 5%, but we want to convert this to a decimal, so we have to move that two places to the left. So that's going to be 0.05. And then the T, the time, that's 2 years, so we're going to multiply this by two. So let's go to the calculator. Let's see what that comes out to. Let's see, you've got 500 times 0.05 times 2 years. That comes out to $50. Now, if the question asks you know, how much money do you have after 2 years? Well, you'd have the $50 plus the initial amount, the $500. You'd have to add those together, $550. So that's our first example. Let's go into our second example. But before I do that, if you're getting into Algebra 1 or you're in Algebra 1 already and you want additional help, check out my Learn Algebra 1 video course for sale. It goes through 87 video topics, taking you step by step by step through the beginning of Algebra 1, through the middle, all the way to the end, building on the previous concepts. You can check out the 13 free lessons to see if it's a good fit for you. But it's been taken by a lot of students already. They've benefited. I know you will too. So go ahead and check that out. But let's go to example number two now. It says if you borrow $1,200 for 3 years and you owe $90 in simple interest, what is the interest rate? Okay, so this problem is a little bit different in the sense that we're not actually solving for I, we're solving for R. Okay, so the first thing that I like to do, and I recommend to the students that I tutor in person, is go ahead and write down that formula, first. Number one, it helps you to memorize it, but number two, it kind of helps you to organize what you know and what you need to solve for. So in this case, we know that the interest is $90, right? And then the principal, we know that's the starting amount, that's the amount that you're borrowing, the 1200. The interest rate we don't know, so let's just call that R. And then the T, the time is 3 years. So we're gonna put in three in place of T. So if we simplify here, 1200 times three is 3600 times R equals 90. We just wanna get R by itself. So we're gonna do the opposite of multiplying by 3600. We're gonna divide both sides by 3600 to get R by itself. Now let's go to the calculator. 90 divided by 3600 is 0.025. Okay, so our interest rate is 0.025, but this is just a decimal. We have to convert it into a percentage by moving that decimal two places to the right. So that's gonna be 2.5%.